Hello. Today, we're going to discuss the topic of how to turn your skills and talents into a business. As we think about this topic, we want to ask the question, what are skills and talents? As we define these terms, we see a skill is the ability to do something well. It has to do with expertise and a particular ability. A talent is a natural aptitude or skill. So when you think about a skill and a talent, they kind of go hand in hand, but they're not exactly the same. I like to think about it like this. Michael Jordan was talented as a basketball player. He had a natural aptitude to play basketball. He was great. Some argue the greatest of all time. Now, he took those natural abilities to play basketball, and he developed his talent into a skill that made him someone who was far above everyone else. Okay, he took these natural talents and he, made them into his own, and he developed these skills and he developed an expertise in the area of basketball. He did this specifically in the area of his defensive prowess. He was great. He was a great defensive player. People know him as a scorer, but he was also a great defensive player. And I only mention that by way of illustration. He could have just used his natural talents, and that would have gotten him so far. But he used his natural talents, and he grew in those natural talents and became one of the greatest players, if not the greatest player of all time. So, what skills do you have? Communication, organizational skills, money management, time management, software knowledge, programming knowledge. You want to take these skills. Again, the skills are the things that you have acquired, and we're going to go into this in more detail. These are a bit different than talents, but these skills that you have to grow in, right? So if you have a natural aptitude to communicate, that's something that you consider as a talent. You can take that talent and develop that skill and become an expert in the area of communication and organization and money management and et cetera. Now, with that being said, we want to look here at the difference between hard skills versus soft skills. Hard skills are specific and quantifiable knowledge or abilities, usually absolutely necessary for success. They can be demonstrated through tangible evidence, such as a degree, certificate, or examples of work. And these are examples below: computer skills, foreign languages, math skills, programming skills, etc. On the other hand, soft skills are unquantifiable attributes that cannot be proven but must be demonstrated through work style and approach. Successful demonstration of soft skills is left to subjective opinion. And some examples below we see are communication, leadership, teamwork, creativity, etc. So what talents do you have? Public speaking, relationship building, strategic planning, encouragement, leadership, creativity. You want to sit down and think about what talents do you have, what skills do you have, and how can you further develop those talents into something that is more of an expertise, something you have an expertise in. There's a quote here by Benjamin Franklin. He says, "Hide not your talents, they for use were made. What's a sundial in the shade?" And that's exactly that. You have a talent. It's your sundial, as it were. And if you are not utilizing this talent by growing in your skills, then you're only hiding it in the shade. And it's not able to benefit you in regards to your small business. And it's not able to benefit those who you want to serve. So you want to take your gifts, your talents, and your skills, and you want to think about, number one, how can you utilize these natural abilities and these acquired skills to benefit you and your business? And in doing so, how can you benefit others who are interested in your services Or how can you help them to see that they need your services? And with that, you want to identify your strengths. What are your strengths? Are you kind? Are you organized? Are you someone who is impulsive? Are you loyal? Are you focused, persistent, optimistic? Are you clever, empathetic, driven? These are all areas that can be weaknesses, right? They can be, but they can also be utilized as strengths, okay? And these are areas that you need to be thinking about when it comes to your personality, when it comes to your vision and your dream for your business. Number one, you can do this, but there has to be a recognition of who you are and who you're not, and then consideration on taking those attributes about yourselves and using them to move forward with respect to your small business. Now, in an article written, linked below, titled 10 Ways to Turn Your Skills into a Successful Business, the writer states 10 ways to turn your skills into a successful business. This is what he says. Number one, he says, find the market rate for your skills. In other words, how much does this area that you desire to go into actually pay? What is the need of the people in your area? And you want to take this into consideration, where you live and what are the needs. Do you live in a blue collar or a white collar society in the area that you live? You want to tailor your business for the area that you're working in, because again, those are going to be your customers. So you want to find the market rate for your skills. Okay. So you have communication skills. Is there a need in your area? And could this be something that is turned into a small business for communication? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe you need to acquire a new set of skills, and the skills that you have that don't necessarily fit for the context that you live in now can be utilized later or in different ways. But maybe a different set of skills would be helpful for the area that you live in. So you want to take that all into consideration. Number two, we see that you want to build up your presence on social media. And this is important. Most people that you work with are going to be online. Now, you're not limited to online, obviously, but you want to expand your business. And one of the ways that you can expand your business is by having a social media presence. Okay, you want people to know who you are and to know what it is you have to offer them. And you want them to know why this is beneficial for them. And in order to do that is you want to get your message out to as many people as possible so that you can potentially have more customers, which will in turn out into more income for you and would most benefit those who are interested in your product. So you want to build up your presence on social media. Third, you want to design your own website to share your talents. Now, thankfully, there are many ways for you to go about this. You yourself don't have to design it, but you can easily just learn and research how to get your own website. And there's different platforms where all you need to do is input certain amount of information, and now you have your own business online via the website. And so you want to look into that. Fourthly, we see here that you want to develop your own online courses. Now, thankfully, again, you can do this free of charge online through sites like YouTube, right? YouTube is a great place for you to have an online course. And you can just, again, there's other sites where people can pay you for your services as you have courses. But YouTube is a great place for people to know who you are and the kind of content that you can produce and the kind of person you are and the personality that you have. They can see that there on YouTube. And again, you can say, well, I don't have a camera. I don't have expensive equipment. Well, you can utilize your phone for now. If you have a smartphone, which most do, not everyone does, but most do, you can utilize your smartphone. Just turn the camera around, press record, and start talking. And the authenticity of just that means of people being able to see you, see that you have your phone that you're using or just minimal equipment, And you're, but the content that you're sharing, the message that you're communicating is something that people can resonate with. And in time, you can grow in these areas. So again, you want to develop online courses. Okay. That's another option. Number five, you want to share your skills as an online coach. Now, again, you have to have skills in order to promote these skills. Okay. You can't say that you have skills and then try to coach people and not have those skills. So this is taking into effect that you actually have skills to offer. One of the means by which you can grow in your business is to have an online presence and be a coach to people in this area. Six, you can consider taking your skills to a freelance market. Again, I would just Google freelance marketing online. There's Fiverr.com that you can do. There's Upwork. There's different areas, Skillshare, where you can go online, Udemy. There's LinkedIn. These are places where you can potentially share your skills online and you can have a freelance marketing business. Or this can be something that we call a side hustle, where you can be making money on the side as you are sharing your skills with the world and people pay you for your skills. Seventh, you can also start writing a blog. Again, you can utilize the website that you started and start writing about the particular area of expertise that you have and start writing a blog in this area. Eighth, you can write down your knowledge in an ebook. Oh, writing a book today is easier than probably has ever been the case. You can go online and look on YouTube and see how to start an ebook, and you'll be able to get tons of videos on how to start an ebook. But again, you have to be knowledgeable in an area. And lest you be discouraged, I want to remind you that, you know, if you dedicated a year of your life or months of dedicated time to study in a particular area or two, you can be the expert in that area. That, and again, the options are limitless, right? There are people who are interested in all kinds of topics. And as long as there is a need in that area that can bring about income for you and provide a service for people, they will pay you. So if you take that knowledge and you put it into a book, people will buy it if it meets a need. So that's another option to consider. Number nine, you can get creative with your skills and design and sell products. Again, there are plenty of options online for you to do this. There's, if you wanted to sell merchandise or clothing, you can do teespring.com, where you can create your own designs or your own messages on a t-shirt and create a small business that way, or at least bring in supplementary income that can help provide for your business. And lastly, here of the options and suggestions that are given in this article is broadcast your skills by making videos and podcasts. Again, the videos you can utilize on YouTube. Just make videos from your phone, or if you have more expensive equipment, you can use that. Upload them on YouTube, or you can upload them on your website and share them from there on your different social media platforms. Another option is for you to use a podcast. You say, well, Edwin, I don't know how to do podcasting. Again, this is just going to require some research, but it isn't difficult. If you go to, for example, one option that is free is anchor.fm, you will be able to record a podcast free of charge from your phone. So if you have a smartphone, you can record and edit your podcast, add background music, sounds, and effects, all from your mobile app, and you will be able to promote your business that way. Then you'd be able to share all your content from the podcast on the different areas of social media that you're on. So if you're on Twitter or Instagram or Facebook and all these other platforms, TikTok or wherever it is that you're on, you can promote your business on there. So there are so many options, and obviously this is only 10 of many options, but I just want you to know and to be encouraged that there are so many resources out there for you that you either don't have to pay for, which are free of charge, or that you can pay for at a minimal cost that will prepare you with the knowledge to be successful with respect to starting your own business. Now, how do you open your own business? There's three steps here. And again, all this is going to require you to do some research. Take a day, take a week, take a month, take a year, and prepare yourself with knowledge and study how to open your own business. Well, step one, you want to brainstorm business ideas. You know your gifts, you know your talents, you know your skills. You want to take all that information into account as you brainstorm ideas for your business. And these are some questions or some ideas to think about. Starting a business from scratch, is that what you want to do? Or do you want to buy a business? Maybe you want to start a franchise. Okay, those are some things to think about. Step two, you want to get a business plan. You want to do some strategic planning. You want to create a simple business plan. You want to create a detailed business plan. On and on and on it goes. You want to think about all these things. And step three, you want to set up a LLC or a sole proprietor. And those are two different things. And what I would encourage you to do is look up that information online. You can also go to the website irs.gov to find out what works best for you and for your business. Now, some practical advice. You obviously want to do your homework, and that's something that we've talked about here so far. And some of the ways in which you can do that is read books. You can watch videos and listen to online teaching on the topic of starting your own small business, or how to use your talents to start your business, or how to use your skills to start a business, or what are the best skills to acquire in order to start my own business, and on and on and on. These questions that you can ask and search and learn in about so that you can do your homework thoroughly. Well, another one is you want to find other like-minded people. You want to look in your community. You want to look online at different social media groups and see where like-minded people are so that when you have questions or when you are researching and you need just a direct insight on particular resources that might be best suited for your niche, you want a community of like-minded people that you can reach out to. Then we see that you want to find a mentor or a coach. And again, you can find a mentor or a coach through books. You can also find them, as we mentioned earlier, through online. You can watch videos or listen to audiobooks, etc. But you also want to consider having a mentor or a coach that you can tangibly see, right? That you can talk to, that you can ask questions to, face-to-face interaction. You can find one at a local business, right? Maybe a friend in the family or someone who knows someone. Remember, as you're networking, as you're out there talking to people, getting to know who they are, getting to rub shoulders with people and, you know, be presentable and, you know, make yourself available to different outreaches or whatever the case is, you're meeting people. And now, as you meet people, you may come across someone who you would love to mentor you, and you can ask that person, okay, to be your mentor, to coach you. Again, also an established organization. You can do a study on different organizations. They have, there's a book on, you know, the genesis of Walmart. How did Walmart get started? You can do a research study on that and just really dig your heels into that and get to know the minds of those who are successful and what it was that made them successful. And so you can have those books and those people as mentors and coaches for you. Now, for more information, I want to give you a couple of resources here. Jamestown Community College has Small Business Development Center, and the website is below. It's sbdcjcc.org. And I would encourage you to go there and look up the information they have for more detail. Also, we see that the Fredonia Technology Incubator has an entrepreneurial education program that is worth looking into as well. And the website is below, www.fredonia.edu. edu, / about, / offices, / Fredonia Technology Incubator. Then we see the Office of Small Business Development Centers. This is www.sba.gov. This is another option for you to consider. And then the USA Grant Applications. This is www.usagrantapplications.org. Now, if you don't get anything else from this, and I hope you do, but if you don't, the point I want you to get home is this. All this is going to require research and study and time, right? Again, you have this seed of a thought in your mind. You want to start a business, okay? That's one. That's the genesis of it. Then you take your skills and your talents, and maybe you stop there because you say, well, I don't really have any talents. Okay, well, now you stop and you go, I don't really have any skills. So you stop there and you say, what skills can I pursue? And how long is it going to take me to pursue this skill? Now, that may or may not entail you going to school. Okay, you don't necessarily need to go to college in order to acquire a skill that can help you to start your own business. But you need to do the homework on that. And you need to ask people and you need to get some wisdom from people and maybe talk to people that have been there and done that and get their insight on what you think, on what they think you should do. But again, this is going to take time. This is going to take research. This is going to take some determination and some mental fortitude for you to continue to move forward with this. And again, this is your dream. This is your vision. This is what you want to help provide for you and for your family, but this is also something that you believe the world will be better with. And so because of that, it's worth pursuing. And it's also going to be a lot of work. So you want to be well informed. And I want to give you the resources in order to accomplish those ends. Now, with that being said, this has been a Chautauqua Works recording. And if you would like to speak to a representative from Chautauqua Works, please feel free to contact us. Our North County Dunkirk office information is below, as well as our South County Jamestown information. If you have any questions that you'd like to ask a career specialist or a youth navigator, please do not hesitate to call this number and to ask for one of us. We would be glad to assist you with the information given here. We would be glad to give you more resources if you are interested, but we want to see you succeed. And we know that that is going to take a lot of work and a lot of effort. And because of that, we want you to know that we are here for you and that we want to see this take place. So again, give us a call. Our information is here and we look forward to hearing from you.